This is Tumuna TV News. I'm Francisca Peter. Governor of Morobe Province, Kasiga Kelly Naro, has called on the people to critically analyze the situation surrounding the ongoing political impasse between the Prime Minister and university students. He made this call during a recent gathering here in Lae.
There have been many turn of events amidst the occurrence of the ongoing political standoff between the Prime Minister and university students from certain institutions. An example of which was the rampage in Mount Hagentown and the shooting of several UPNG students. The governor of Morobe at a recent gathering urged the people not to take sides but critically analyze the situations surrounding the issue before making a stance, but in a rather amicable way. He stated that at such time, there still needs to be more clarity on what the real issues are and the actual problem surrounding the standoff.
Without an appreciation and understanding of the true facts and circumstances and the issues surrounding this matter, you will never ever be able to appreciate the full context and extent of what is happening. Now, you will be influenced by emotions, you will be influenced by social judgment, or even moral judgment for that matter, or your traditional judgment and considerations, and by affecting CW, family, and our community.
The governor stated that despite the university students and certain non-governmental organizations' call for the Prime Minister to step aside and allow to be investigated as mandated in the country's law, the Prime Minister in response is also using the country's constitution and law to assert himself. Governor Naro, a lawyer by profession, adds that it is now a question of who is rightfully interpreting the law and how will the law be able to solve this issue.
Because of this, we have had over five weeks of total impasse on this issue. The time we set up the parliament of last week Friday, we explaining the Papua New Guinea with Dokosem, and unfortunately, the media did not report me, and they never basically asked me for my view so that I could explain properly. What I said was this: because of the current impasse that we are going through now, Papua New Guinea, this nation, is now going through an unprecedented season of people passing judgment, people dispensing justice. And when it comes to the notion of justice, you can have all sorts of justice being dished out. There's the notion of moral justice. You've broken law of the church, you've broken law of the Bible, you've broken law of the big man. I'll do what I talk about of you. This is moral justice. Arbla and of social justice. According to social behavior, social perception, how people see things happening, they pass their own social judgment. And over the last few weeks, the social sector judgment has been hitting the front line like nobody's business. People have been passing judgment in the mainstream media, in the print media, in the broadcast media, in the electronic media, in the social media. Every day, people are commenting on Facebook. Faceless people are coming on Facebook to say this and that. You also have people dishing out tribal justice. A particular clan and particular tribe and particular this and that is doing this and that. Unfortunately, in terms of the notion of justice, our constitution, Mama Love Longimi, Section 155 of the Constitution says that the function of dispensation of justice can only be performed by the national judicial system.
Speaking at the gathering, Governor Naro stated that in the current impasse, everyone involved is concerned about justice, yet their motives are being influenced by other factors. The governor added that what the people involved in the impasse should consider and embrace is on achieving justice according to the laws of the country or legal justice without assimilating moral, personal, emotional, social or other values with the appropriate form of justice.
Justice according to law can only be dispensed by the appropriately prescribed and qualified authority, and that is the national judicial system, and the national judicial system comprises of the Supreme Court, the National Court, District Court, Local Court, and all other appropriately authorized courts and bodies. Nobody, no one outside of the national judicial system is empowered to pass judgment. So you see my point. Why is everybody passing judgment left, right, and center? People are calling for the Prime Minister to resign. People are calling for him to step down. People are calling for him to face the investigation. And they are saying, that's because the law says so. Well, unfortunately, you are up against a brick wall because the Prime Minister is saying, the same law also gives me the right to seek protection of the law, which I am also seeking. So who is right and who is wrong? You think it? Me not supporting Prime Minister, me not supporting opposition, me not supporting Musa Dusan, but I am supporting the notion of justice and the notion of dispensation of justice according to law, legal justice. And when it comes to the dispensation of legal justice, only the courts can dispense justice. Not you and me, not everybody else. And the matter that the university students are fighting over, it is before the courts. The matter the Prime Minister is seeking legal protection over, it is before the courts. The question of the UBS law, it is before the courts. All these things are before the courts. We have asked the courts to basically pass judgment on these matters. The wheels of justice has been set in motion. What are we doing now? We are preempting and we are prejudging and we are giving our views on who is right and who is wrong. Who gave you the mandate to do that? Who says so?
On stating that the matters being argued on in the standoff have already been brought before the court at this time, he urged all parties involved to exercise restraint.
The consequence and implication of this is this. We just now have to shut up, exercise restraint, be patient, and let justice prevail. Have you said that? Now you understand. Prime Minister Kim explained the simple school. He has stated that the same law that you are arguing that I should abide by, this is the same law I am seeking protection under. He's given this explanation. So what more do you want? You are jeopardizing your education, my dear students. I am telling you, Borno Province replied, investing big from money in the Otsumatim, you must think it good. No can waste him education blow you. Papa Mama give him big help him the support the government blow you to give him. You go to prison school. This is the issue that you are passing judgment on. Unfortunately, section 155 of the constitution says that this judgment, the notion of legal justice, can only be dispensed by the appropriately empowered institution, and that institution is the courts. Not you, not me. Not the emotions, not the social observations, not Facebook, not faceless people on Facebook.
Governor Kelly Narrow finally reminded the parties involved that such was a test of great patience for them and that they should give time and respect for the system of justice to take its course. Francisca Peter reporting for Tumuna TV News, Leigh.